Hello, welcome to Analytics in 15. And today's session, we are going to discuss about what's new with Amazon QuickSight. My name is Srikant Bahati, and I am Senior Worldwide Solutions Architect with Amazon QuickSight. Let's look at our agenda. Today, we are going to cover introduction to QuickSight. We'll jump in and look at how QuickSight has been evolving. So we'll look at our pace of innovation. I'll give a quick sneak peek on paginated reports. And then we'll look at what's new with QuickSight Q and end with a brief demo. Let's get started with introduction to QuickSight. QuickSight, so why Amazon QuickSight, right? All of these legacy systems where you have different products sitting in different reports. So for example, your reports sit in a different product, your dashboards sit in a different product, your embedded analytics are using a separate suite of products, and your NLQ and your machine learning is happening in one other product. So you have silos that are happening as part of your reporting requirements. With QuickSight, you can bring them into a unified BI service at hyperscale, where you will not have to train your resources on variety of products, whereas you will end up training them in just one product, that is QuickSight. Next, we'll look at some of the benefits of Amazon QuickSight. Amazon QuickSight, as I said, is a unified BI service which fits all your needs under a single belt. That includes your paginated reports, your dashboards, your embedded analytics, and acts as a single source of truth. Second, you can build your reports, dashboards, and all your insights at a much faster pace because QuickSight offers all the APIs, extensive APIs for rapid development, for rich analytics. Three, QuickSight is completely serverless and versionless, which means you do not have to worry about any hardware, or you do not have to worry about any maintenance of versions, upgrades, etc. And at the same time, you can scale from tens of users to hundreds of thousands of users. Finally, you might be thinking, with all these great features, it might cost you a fortune. No, QuickSight can get more with less, which means QuickSight is pay-as-you-go service. You do not have any long-term licensing. You do not need to plan anything. As you're onboarding users, as your users are using QuickSight, you end up paying for what they are using. These are some of the benefits. Now, let's look at how in real world customers are using QuickSight. Today, QuickSight customers use QuickSight much like in an interactive fashion, building their dashboards, visualizations, use it for ad hoc analysis, all these at scale. With embedded analytics, what QuickSight offers is you can not only just cater these insights to your internal audience, but you can also target your external audience and embed these insights into your external applications where your users will not be part of Amazon QuickSight, but they can still access these insights. Finally, recently at reInvent, we launched something called paginated reporting, which means now you no longer have to maintain those separate systems for your paginated reports, pixel perfect reports. You can export them in PDF formats and highly formatted CSVs, highly formatted reports and CSVs. And at the same time, you can enable subscriptions on your reports, which can be delivered to your end users' inbox in the form of CSV. Next, we will look into pace of innovation. Let's see how QuickSight has been evolving over the years. We always work backwards from our customers. So back in 2018, we started with usage-based pricing. We did large-scale deployments. 2019, we launched ML Insights, dashboard embeddings. 2020, we launched Q, which is natural language querying capabilities as part of Amazon QuickSight. 21, we launched alerts, personalizations, and a lot other BI features. And 2022 was a great year where we have launched like serverless paginated reports. As part of our natural language querying, we launched why type of questions and forecasting. When it comes to embedding, we have launched visual embedding and one-click embedding. So all these features, which like in last few couple of years, we have launched 150 plus features. Next, yes, we were very busy in 2022. Of those 150 features, 80 plus new features were launched in 2022 alone, which includes why questions in queue, visual embedding, automated queue topic generation. We launched QuickSight community, paginated reports. There's a ton of features and rich authoring capabilities that were launched as part of 2022. Let's jump into paginated reporting and what paginated reporting has to offer. As part of paginated reporting, you can create highly formatted multi-page printable reports. What that means is you can create your highly formatted reports, those invoices, those financial statements, those real estate statements, all those highly formatted reports can be generated using paginated reports feature, and they can be generated in thousands of pages, in the form of PDFs, in the form of CSV exports. You can do all of those as part of paginated reporting. Another thing that paginated reporting offers is specifically scheduling an email delivery of reports to your external audience and to your internal audience, wherein these can be scheduled at a given time when this report will be generated and be delivered to your end users in their inbox. And what is the beauty about this is all this is serverless, so that it can auto scale to your demand, which means like if you have thousands of schedules that you want to execute for different types of report on different users, you do not have to worry about the scalability, and QuickSight can automatically handle that for you. Lastly, I would like to point out that if you want to learn more about paginated reports, we have an upcoming webinar on Wednesday, 27th of March at 9 a.m. PST. Next, we'll look at what's new with QuickSight Q. As part of our natural language querying that was launched back in 2022, that itself was very exciting feature. But what is more exciting is over the last 2 years, how much investments we have made to make Q even more user-friendly. One of the features that includes is automated data preparation. We have heard from our customers that, hey, data preparation and creation of topics, enhancement and enrichment of topics is a very time-taking process. So as part of 2022, our team has worked on launching a feature called auto-generation of Q topic, which makes it really straightforward. Once you have a dashboard, you take that dashboard, you pass it to, you create a Q topic out of the dashboard based on what vocabulary and what calculated fields, what fields are used in the dashboard. QuickSight will now be able to generate an automatic topic for you, which you can review and be able to then hand it over to your users for use. Next, we'll talk about QuickSight Q why questions and forecast questions. So QuickSight Q launched why questions. A lot of times we know, okay, what are my sales? We know what type of questions. QuickSight Q was able to handle those beautifully. What is average? What is min, median? What is comparison? QuickSight was able to do that beautifully. With why type of questions, now you can see here, you can ask, why did my sales drop in January, and get exact insights and contribution analysis on top of your why question. Second thing that we have launched is forecast type of questions. You would like to forecast, we all know, everyone wants to predict the future. You all want to know how my year 2023 is going to look like, or I want to see how my sales is going to be, how my demand for my inventory is going to be. So for all those type of questions, QuickSight has launched forecast questions where you can start asking, show me forecasts of orders for New York by month, for example, here. And you can see that yellow shaded region shows the forecast for the question asked. Finally, we have added another feature called pin visuals for easy access using Q, which means now all these questions that are being asked as an author user, you will be able to, or as a reader user or author user, you will be able to take this visual that is generated based off of your question and pin to your board. You can create your own board where you can pin all the frequently asked questions, frequent insights you are interested in. Let's look at a demo of forecast and why questions in QuickSight Q. Here, we are going into a Q topic, and we are going to go ahead and start asking simple questions. Show me sales by month. And QuickSight will be able to show us that sales by month trend based on the question asked. It's going to look at the sales by month. Now I want to forecast, so I'm going to go ahead and change forecast sales by month. As you can see, QuickSight Q is now able to go ahead and forecast forecast data based on the question asked by month, and it is going to do period forward by that. Next, I would like to know why did my sales increase in December. Can ask why type of questions, and QuickSight Q will now show us details of like sales increased here because of compared to November, it increased by that much, and it was because here city was a key driver for changes in sales, country is a key driver for changes in sales. And you can further see if you can change here and see how was in industry ranked, whether industry was one of the thing, and energy industry increased by 210%. That was you can change and see the contribution analysis. You can do the contribution analysis based on the why type of questions here. As you can see, I'm going to go ahead and see how did my segment fare. And in the segment, it was only like 21% sale for SMB increase. So you have those knobs and hooks where you can go ahead and change and see those contribution analysis and make sense out of your insights. Now, let's get back to our slides. I would like to share some resources. We have our product page. We have some demos listed on our Demo Central. For those of you who want to try QuickSight hands-on, we have workshops. You can go through our workshops. And I highly recommend going and adding yourself or registering as part of our QuickSight community. There's a lot of excitement going on in the community. There's a lot of questions being asked, questions being answered, a lot of learning happening, a lot of blogs being published, technical papers being published. So please feel free to go ahead and register in our QuickSight community and be part of our community and contribute towards the success of QuickSight with us. With that, I would like to thank you all.